Hari Hari. So we'll continue our daily Bhagavad Gita study. We're on text number 2 of the first chapter of the Bhagavad Gita. Sanjaya uvacha drishtva tu pandavani kam vyudam duryodhanastada acharyam upasangamya raja vachanam abravit. So in this verse, Sanjaya is answering the question that Dhritarashtra had previously, right? Dhritarashtra's question that we went over yesterday is, my sons and the sons of Pandu, they're at this place of pilgrimage, Dharmakshetra. They're there having a battle. What's going on? And we went through that. So today, in this verse, Sanjaya is answering that question. Sanjaya says, basically, your son, Duryodhan, he has looked over the battlefield. He sees the Pandavas have arrayed the military, their army, into a powerful formation. He becomes worried. Srila Prabhupada tells us in the purport that Duryodhana becomes fearful, and he goes running to Dronacharya and he's about to speak. That's today's verse. First of all, those of us who know the Mahabharata, the story, we know Duryodhana's character. He assaults women, he's a thief, he's an attempted murderer, so on and so forth. But even Duryodhana has a teacher, Dronacharya. He's going to speak now to his teacher, Dronacharya. Even a person of the character of Duryodhana has a teacher. Regardless of his other character flaws. Now his desire to interact with Dronacharya is selfish. He has Dronacharya because he wants Dronacharya either to teach him military science or to run his army as commander-in-chief. So it's not to the benefit of Dronacharya, obviously. It's Duryodhana, he's motivated by his own selfish desires and wants. But even so, he has a teacher. What we can take from this, what we can learn from this, is that we should not be so egomaniacal, arrogant, puffed up, so involved in ourselves that we do not have the ability to learn. We do not have the ability to gain knowledge from whatever source possible. To gain knowledge, wisdom, understanding, to never be beyond the ability to learn, to never be beyond the ability to listen, to think or have a mentality that we know I can teach you, but I cannot learn. Let me teach you. Let me tell you how this should be. We should never have such an arrogant mentality, such an arrogant personality that we cannot learn. Oftentimes we have this with our closest people, right? Our spouse. How can I learn something from my husband, from my wife, from my children? I coach soccer. I have an assistant coach. It's a person who has never it's a person who's never played soccer before. Wonderful person. Never played soccer before, doesn't know much about soccer, but the person helps me manage as I need to do so. I learn. I must be sure that just because I've played soccer, I've coached soccer in the past, I'm not above learning from my assistant coach about how to take care of, how to develop exercises for the kids in order for them to play soccer, learn soccer. We should never be above the ability to learn. There was Thomas Carlyle, the great Scottish thinker, philosopher, mathematician of the 20th century. And he said, an incredible realization. He said, all people are superior to me in that I can learn from them. Emerson said something similar to that. All people are superior to me in that I can learn from them. This is a mentality, this is a quality we all should cultivate in all of our relationships. Even in the relationships of those with those persons whom we have, whom we don't like, even our enemies, we should cultivate for ourselves the ability to learn. Never be so arrogant, never be so self-centered that we do not recognize it a person, we can learn from a person. A friend, a spouse, an enemy, someone we do not like, someone who annoys the bejesus out of us, we can learn. Because the flip side of that, the opposite mentality is, I know, I know, I know. We cut ourselves off from knowledge. We cut ourselves off from wisdom. What we know is only a fraction of the wisdom and knowledge available to us in our sphere of existence. Just in our sphere of existence, not even beyond that. In our current relationships, in our current sphere of existence, there is a vast amount of knowledge that we will cut ourselves off from if we have a mentality of, I know, there's nothing you can teach me. It is very important that we never lose, or we develop the ability to always be able to learn. To learn, to listen, learn. Keep an open mind, an open heart. Now this takes an incredible strength of character. And this is indicated by Stephen Covey. In Stephen Covey's Seven Habits of Highly Effective People, one of my favorite books, he defines humility. I find it to be an incredible definition of humility. He says we should not, or humility is not to think less of ourselves, but to think of ourselves less. In other words, we should not think that we are somehow deficient. I'm not talking about deficiency. I'm talking that we should not have this idea, an overinflated idea or perception of ourselves, that it precludes us from gaining knowledge, gaining wisdom, being able to understand. That's going to broaden our experience in life. That's going to broaden our ability to successfully live. Forget spiritually. That's on a whole different level. And that's going to come in verses after this. Spiritually, that's another thing. But just outside of our so-called spiritual life, in our day-to-day existence, we should cultivate the ability to listen and learn that there are things that we do not know. When we look to our wife, when we look to our husband, our children, our boss, our co-workers, we can learn from any number of sources. This mentality of learning, listening to learn, to understand, to gain wisdom, to gain knowledge. I do not know everything. I do not have full wisdom. I do not have full understanding. That this person may be an absolute idiot when it comes to some things. However, in this issue, I can learn. This is not so much about, although it enhances our relationships to have this mentality. The mentality itself is going to uplift us. The mentality itself is going to put us in a place that is beneficial to our relationships, beneficial to our existence, beneficial to every other aspect of our life. The ability to shut up and learn. The ability to stop teaching. The ability to stop trying to give our opinion, share what we want to, what we know over what others may have to offer. To actually have conversations, even in this 5 minute, 10 minute miniature lecture. I hope and I expect to receive all kinds of emails, discussions. I teach and share Bhagavad Gita, and the more I share, the more I learn. But we should not, this verse is a verse about ego. What we can learn from this verse is how to set aside our ego so that we can be open to knowledge. And this requires daily, every single day, various, throughout the day, we're going to have opportunities when we have to set aside our ego and listen, learn, gain knowledge, gain wisdom. I'll end there, and tomorrow we'll go on to text number 3. Hari Hari.